Hi everybody, it's lovely to see you again this week. Another week here on Kids Church Online, and we're another week closer to when we'll all be back together again, which is great. Well, what have we got planned for today? Well, Megan is going to finish telling us all about Joseph. I really hope the story has the happy ending we hope it has. We've got Belinda, who's going to be giving us a quiz on all the things we've been doing for the last 4 weeks. We're going to revisit Rebecca and her teaspoon prayer from last week, so watch out for the falling teaspoon. And then, before we do any of that, we've got a couple of photographs of you that you've been sending in of all of your attempts to fill our challenges, and it's really lovely to see that everybody's still out there and everybody's enjoying Kids Church.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord Most High. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are saved. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord Most High. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord Most High. The name of the
Kids Church Online this morning. I am so glad that you are back with us this week because we are finishing off Joseph's story. Last week we left off with the fact that Joseph had interpreted and read Pharaoh's dreams and that he had told him that there was going to be these 7 years of good harvest in Egypt. But unfortunately, it was going to be followed by 7 years of famine, which means no food. And Joseph had to decide on a plan that was going to save Egypt. And he did this all with the help of God. So things were looking pretty well for Joseph. Pharaoh was impressed with him. He had saved the people of Egypt. He wasn't going to be hungry. Nobody was going to have to die. But at the very end, do you remember what Joseph was worried about? Yes. If you said that he was worried about his family, you were right. Remember his brothers and his dad from the start of the story? The ones that sold him? Yes, those brothers. He was worried about them. So it shows us the type of person that Joseph was, that he still cared about them even after what they had done on him. So let's watch our story this week and find out what happens to the brothers and Joseph when they get reunited. Hi everyone, welcome to my palace. This week has been a really exciting week for me because I have been promoted to prince by the pharaoh because he was so impressed with the work that I've been doing on storing up all the food so that the people of Egypt have enough to eat when the famine hits, and it's going to be happening really soon. However, I am starting to get worried because the people outside of Egypt haven't been doing the same things that we have, so they're going to be hungry and some people might actually starve to death, which would be awful. And it's made me start to think about my family back in Canaan, and they're not going to have enough food, and I'm just so worried about what might happen then because there are so many of my brothers, it's going to be impossible for them to get enough food. It's just really making me sad. Now, back at home, Joseph's brothers had ran out of food and everyone was hungry. God's special family was in danger. If they did not get food soon, they would starve to death. So Joseph's brothers travelled to Egypt to buy food. They came and knelt before the new prince. His brothers did not know that the prince was Joseph, but Joseph knew who they were. Joseph's dream, the one where his brothers were bowing down to him, was coming true. So as soon as the people came in, I knew exactly who they were. I knew that my brothers looked different. They're older, their hair's a bit different, they're taller, but even after all these years, I still could tell that it was them. Because I remembered back to the dream I had whenever I was younger and still living at home, that my brothers would come to me and be bowing down in front of me, and that's exactly what happened. However, they didn't recognise me. I was a completely different person to what the Joseph they knew all those years ago, and they weren't expecting me to be the prince in Egypt. So I'm not surprised that they didn't recognise me, but I wonder what they'll think whenever they know it's me. "It's me," Joseph cried. When they saw it was Joseph, his brothers were afraid. They had wronged Joseph. They had sinned and they knew it. Now Joseph would certainly punish them. So Joseph now has a big decision to make. He needs to decide whether he is going to be cross with his brothers and be angry for all the things that they have done to him. Because after all, they have been really mean. And Joseph even has the power now to throw them in prison. Or the other option is that he forgives his brothers. He forgets about all the bad things that they have done and instead chooses to love and care for them. Let's look and see at the two possible situations that could happen and how they might play out. "I can't believe you did that to me all those years ago. How could I ever forgive you? Guards, take them to the prisons and they will never get out." Even after all this time and everything that happened, my heart is still so full of love for you, brothers. I'm not cross. I'm not angry. I'm just happy to see you and know that you're okay. Let me give you a hug. So, what do you think is going to happen? Do you think Joseph is going to be
A, angry Joseph, or B, forgiving Joseph? But Joseph looked at his brothers and his eyes filled with tears. Even though his brothers had hurt him and hated him and wanted him dead, in spite of everything, he couldn't stop loving them. His heart, which they had broken, filled up with love, and Joseph forgave them.
Joseph threw his arms around them. "Don't be afraid," he said. "Behind what you were doing, underneath everything that was happening, God was doing something good. God was making everything right." One day, God would send another prince, a young prince, whose heart would break. Like Joseph, he would leave his home and his father. His brothers would hate him and want him dead. He would be sold for pieces of silver. He would be punished even though he had done nothing wrong. But God would use everything that happened to this young prince, even the bad things, to do something good, to forgive the sins of the whole world.
So what a wonderful end to Joseph's story. He is reunited with his family and they live the rest of their lives in Egypt, safe and healthy. And from Joseph's story, we can learn lots of important lessons that we've been learning about the past couple of weeks. But let's do a little recap just in case some people have forgotten. Number one is to always be kind to others. So we saw at the start of the story that Joseph maybe wasn't the kindest to his brothers. He boasted about his dreams and made them feel a bit weak about themselves. Now, Joseph's brothers definitely did not react in the right way by selling him, but we still see that Joseph learned that that wasn't the right thing to do, because every time later on in his life, he realized that he needed to put other people's feelings first. So when he was in Potiphar's house, he didn't tell on the wife whenever she said bad things about him and lies about him. He went to jail even though he was innocent. Then when he was in jail, he worked at the top of the prisoners and was in charge of lots of different people, making sure that they were all okay. He helped the butler and the baker in jail by reading their dreams, and the butler ended up getting out because of it. And then, of course, he helped all the people of Egypt to have enough food when the famine came. So we can see how kind Joseph was, and that's all because he had learnt from the situation at the start of the story. And that was God showing him that he needed to do that. The second thing is all to do with forgiveness. Joseph forgave his brothers after they had plotted and planned to kill him and then ended up selling him. Like, when it comes to brothers and sisters, that's really one of the worst things ever. And Joseph didn't hold that against him. He didn't then say to them that they had to be thrown in jail or that he wasn't going to give them any food. Not at all. The first thing he wanted to do was wrap his arms around them and cry in happiness. He was so thrilled that they were okay and healthy, and that's all that mattered to him. And we should think about that in our lives. We should remember that we should forgive others the way Joseph did, and ultimately the way Jesus did. Because we hear at the end of our story today that there is lots of links between Joseph's life and Jesus's life. Jesus was taken away from his Father in heaven and came to earth to save our sins. And he didn't get a lot of thanks for it when he was here. People were mean to him, they didn't follow him, they didn't trust in him, even though he was doing all these incredible things for other people. Bad things still happened to him, but he never got cross, he never got angry, he always did the right thing. But still, he had to die on a cross, and that was all for us, because he loves us and cares for us, and he wanted to save us so that we can be reunited with him in heaven. And what an incredible and amazing message to finish off today's story with. So I hope you enjoyed it. We are going to now pass over to Belinda, and she is going to go on a little quiz with you to recap all the things you have learned over the last 4 weeks.
Well, hello there, everyone, and welcome to our quiz. Our quiz is on Joseph and is there a happy ending? Well, of course, you've just heard the story, so you know all the answers. So let's get our thinking caps on and let's see if you can answer the questions. They're multiple choice, that means you've got three or two choices, and I will give you 10 seconds to think of the answer, maybe to ask someone if you're a bit unsure of it, and then I'm going to tell you the answer, and let's see if we can get all 10 questions right at the end. Right, first question, let's go on here. Where is our story found in the Bible? Okay. Is it A, is it Genesis, B, is it in Mark, or is it C, at the very end of the Bible? We've got 10 seconds to start. Let's see if we can do it, and go. Nearly time. Okay, and the answer is A, Genesis. Did everybody get that? That was quite an easy one to start with because we've been told it each week through the story. Next question. What was happening in Egypt in today's story? Was it A, a famine? That means there was no food and everybody was getting a bit hungry. Was it B, a party? Or was it C, a birthday? Okay, let's start our timer and off we go again. Nearly time. Have you got it? Time's up. Okay, our answer is a famine. It's A again. Did you get that one? That one was quite an easy one because they were dealing with the dreams that Joseph had had as well in the other story. So I hope you remembered that one. Let's go to our next question. Okay, who came to see Joseph in today's story? Was it A, Pharaoh? Was it B, his wife? Or was it C, his brothers? Okay, A, Pharaoh, B, his wife, or C, his brothers. Let's go again. Okay. Okay, did you get it? Yes, it was C this time. It was his brothers. Well done, boys and girls. I think you're doing very well at these questions. Let's see if we can get the next one. Why did they come to see Joseph? Now, did they come to see Joseph to A, pay his taxes or pay their taxes, B, to buy a horse, or was it C, to get some food? Remember, Joseph's brothers, why did they come? Let's start and go. 10 seconds, remember? Okay, and the answer is they came to get some food because there was a famine and they were really hungry. Well done. I know you got that one. Now, this one's just got two answers. Wow. So let's see. You can have a wee chat about it. Did the brothers recognize Joseph? That means, did the brothers know who Joseph was when they came to get their food? A is yes and B is no. And let's start. Let's see. And the timer's up. And the answer is no. I was fooling you a bit by pressing yes there, but it's no. They didn't recognize him. They didn't know who he was. He was going to have to tell them. Okay. Next question. What did the brothers bowing down before Joseph remind Joseph of? Was it A, story he had heard? Was it B, a dream he had had? Or was it C, a coat he had had? So What did the brothers bowing down before him remind him of? Okay, off you go. Thinking. Come on, you can do it. You know this one. And we're nearly there. And time is up. And the answer is, it was a dream. Do you remember? Way back when he was at home with his dad, he had a couple of dreams that he shared with his brothers, and they were all bowing down to him. Wow, that was a good one. I think you all got that one right. Let's try the next one. What did Joseph say to his brothers? Did he say, "It's me"? Did he say, "Go and get your food"? Or did he say, "See, go away"? Which one did he say in today's story? Okay, are you ready to start? Think about it. Off you go. Oh, and time's nearly up. And the answer to this one is, it's A. It's me. He told them that it was him, their brother, and they were absolutely afraid. Let's see what happens next. Why were the brothers afraid? Was it A, they thought Joseph would punish them? B, he was a scary man? Or C, he had a sword? Which do you think it was? Why were the brothers afraid? Let's see. Go! Thinking. Keep it up. Ooh. Time's nearly up. And the answer to this was, they thought Joseph was going to punish them. Do you remember? Because they weren't very nice to Joseph and they'd sold him. So actually they thought they were going to get punishment from Joseph. Let's try the next question. We're nearly there and you're doing so well, I know. What could Joseph not stop doing? Was it A, he couldn't stop hating his brothers? Was it B, he couldn't stop picking his nose? Or was it C, he couldn't stop loving his brothers? Think about this one and go. Nearly there. Keep going. Wow. And it was C, loving his brothers. The picking his nose was really a bit of a funny one, wasn't it? Let's do the next one. What did Joseph do next? He told his brothers who they were, who he was. They were all reunited. And what did he do next? A, did he go on holidays? B, did he rescue his family and brought them to live with him? Or C, did he tell them to go away? What did Joseph do when he spoke to his brothers? Let's go. Thinking, and away you go. Nearly there. Wow. Did you get that one? That one was quite an easy one, wasn't it? Yeah, he rescued his family and he brought them to live with him in Egypt so that they would have enough food to get through the famine. And he forgave them as well for all the horrible things that they had done to him. Wow. And at the end, Joseph had a happy family. And that's the end of our quiz, boys and girls. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you got 10 out of 10 because you've been listening so carefully over the past few weeks. And I'll see you again next week. Bye.
Good morning. We are going to spend some time talking to God again in prayer, and we are going to continue using our teaspoon prayer. So hopefully you've got the chance to use this during the week. Maybe you did a teaspoon prayer when you were out for a walk, or maybe you did a teaspoon prayer when you were about to go to sleep, or maybe it was first thing in the morning. You can do a teaspoon prayer anywhere. So hopefully you've had the chance to do some this week. We are going to just use the same idea as last week. We are going to think about the tea as saying thank you to God. So if you're watching this with people, you might want to share some of those ideas. Then we're going to use the S for saying sorry. So thinking of the things maybe this week that we have done that haven't been so good, or things that we would like to say sorry for. And then the P, last one, is for please. And whenever we ask God for things, he listens to us, and it's really cool that we can bring all of our requests to him. So let's just take some time and pray to God. At the table of the Lord, there is peace at the table. I'm sure you thought of lots of things to be thankful for. I know at the minute whenever I go out for a walk outside, I just look at all the creation. We have so much, especially in Northern Ireland, to be thankful for, with all the beautiful countryside that we live in. Next we're going to say sorry to God, so think about things that maybe we've done wrong for the last little while that we haven't said sorry for yet. And we'll just spend a few minutes thinking about those. You can share them if you want, but we'll just say sorry to God. Lastly, we are going to say please to God. So it could be something personally for ourselves that we need help with, or it could be for other people that we know and we would love God to help them. So you might want to pray and share some of the things with the people you're watching with, but we're going to tell God everything that we need, because he is a God who wants to know all these things. He's a God who wants us to tell him what we need help with, and he wants to help us with it because he is such a good God. So we'll spend a few moments just thinking about all the things we would like to ask God for. Just to finish, we will pray together. Dear God, I thank you for Children's Church this morning. I thank you for everything that we have been learning. I thank you for the gift that is prayer, Lord. I thank you that we can talk to you whenever we want to, and I thank you that you listen. We're sorry for the wrong things that we have done this week. And we thank you that you sent Jesus to die for us, to forgive us from those sins. And please, Lord, help us in this next week. Whatever we're facing, it might be really challenging for us, or it might be for our friends. I pray that you would give us peace and hope and comfort in the middle of it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And remember that you can teaspoon prayer anywhere. You don't have to be here. You don't have to be in your living room. You can take your teaspoon with you. You don't even need a teaspoon. But you can go anywhere and you can pray this little teaspoon prayer. So have another go this week, and I'll see you soon. At his table.